UAP Radio.
Yeah.
of Jesus. complications, distractions, wrong turns, or whatever we do, Dr. Jesus said he'll make everything all right. Dr. Jesus.
Everybody, my name is Roger McClain of UAP Radio. Here where we offer photography, videography, DJing, podcasting, and develop social media / commercial content for business owners, entrepreneurs, educators, organizations, and creatives to help promote their events, products and services, special announcements, promotions, and more. So if you would like to book one of our services or see everything that we have to offer, go to uapradio.com and contact me today at 704-418-1876.
UAP Radio, and for the voice of the Black community.
Before I get started, I'd like for y'all to do me a favor, if you can, and send up some praise and make some noise if you know God's been showing up. In honor of us recognizing men's mental health awareness this month, Juneteenth and Father's Day, these next three pieces are kind of along the lines of those three topics right there through my eyes, and I hope y'all can relate to it. This first one is called Late Hatchling. Hey, excuse me, arrivederci, got a mouth to feed, so it's peace I keep. They killed a lot with the blitz, so you can't tell me it ain't about protecting women or kids in the village. I've got to do it because it's two that I grip. Standing tall in my court without judging your stitch. Ain't no gown on no gavel. Had DNA straddle, don't keep with no saddle with thousands of gallops up. Going down a dirty country road. Catching handsome big mama talking back to grown folk. Because you don't want to go down to the corner store to get the items you know that we can't grow. In our home garden, don't beg for her pardon. Don't work, you don't eat, that's why Black children starving. But knowledge, regardless, I'm not about to argue. My youngin' hit hardest when they on the field. Or shoot at the best in the gym or protect. You will fight for respect, intellect you neglect. Cause your pockets on flesh, claim your drip looking fresh. But you ain't found the time to help children out yet. Man, okay, that's a bet, but keep telling me that. Y'all got a problem with how they doing in the schools when they make up new rules to keep truth from the view. Your solutions to send them the youth and they'll make them a truth. You know that it's true. But we want our daughters and sons to be better than us. So we give them gloves and tell them to run and jump? Because I guess they ain't got brains to bring about change. Nerd gang is for lames. Go work on your range and sing. Because if we keep it real, then we all know the deal. To a lot, them green dollars is worth more than talent and skills. So hush, little babies, don't you cry. No, babies, don't you cry. Lay hashtag. This second piece is dedicated towards the Juneteenth celebration and our freedom. This one's called Black Wall Street Renaissance Restoration. We bicker a lot about the lies we being told. Solutions not being developed, but we already know what they've been doing not conducive to genetic codes that we inherit from ancestors that knew how to grow. They own fools, now them youngest clutching the rugas. Old heads should just be their tutors, cause y'all wisdom measure rulers that had the inch of faith to help them move their feet across them yards, miles on the road that none of them had ever seen before. They had one thing in mind, that they would rather die than live a lie. You stay behind enemy lines, your people will decline. So they all fought till they was caught and never let up off the vision with intentions for us living. If they failed, they tried. Last one. I ain't tripping. This last one is called This Thing Called Life. Speaking on this life that we live, and my life has changed due to my daughter, so this one was for. Hey, at 21, my daughter gave me fight. She helped me with this thing called life. It's only right. I oblige, making sure that she rises up. Higher than I sacrifice fun and bling. Weaponry formed against me won't ever prosper. Now my baby girl called me boring, but still I continue pouring into her time and energy my own wasn't giving me. But indirectly, still he really was preparing me to break the curse from passing on her. Starting over from the dirt is berserk and it irks me. Hearing parents speak, you got to get it how I did. Cause if I do, I ain't out here doing what I'm supposed to. Supposed to mold you like them old coons with the side tooth missing, but they spitting that you gain. You better listen. It helps to aim your precision, cause I've been persistently helping those that's after me become better than me times three. No foe, I'm from the cell, mofo. I was born from the storm, Hurricane Hugo. Giving blood, sweat, and tears till my clothes get soaked. My era flooded with drugs, that's why we dripped in dope. But hold up though, don't wanna go there though. Cause I'm a new school dude and the soul still old. And I can do a 1-2 when I hit the flow. And got a bunch of love ones standing around me, so I hope y'all
I'm not doing that no more. I'm not doing that no more. No, I'm really, but like driving here, it's in me. It's in me, like literally, it's in me. I'm a street kid. Like it's in me. And I am like, you know, you're supposed to question him. I'm like, why you do this? Like early, Unc say, I ain't throwing gang signs. I say, hey, what up with that? So y'all was just in there. I clicked. I'm like, oh, what was that? I'm about to hide myself. You feel me? I had to go to a whole different. Children, y'all was safe. I had y'all. I'm a superhero. But as I was sitting there, my street side come out again. That man got Walls Memorial on his shirt. Now, I grew up in church. Yeah, I just deferred. I had to hide myself. I told y'all. So, it's in Walls Memorial, but I went to Walls Memorial. But I'm looking at them people.
Come on, girl.
Come on. Walls Memorial people on the big leg. I don't know about them. While I'm reading his shirt, too. I'm reading it. But you didn't put the A and me on there. See, it's two different sets. They from Charlotte, we from Shelby. The streets had got me again. I said, all right, you tell me. He said, I'm going to show you the way. I said, oh, well, they ain't that way. We can't get it back out. Something happened to me. We going the wrong way, Lord. They going back to Charlotte. I'm going to Shelby. But the streets is in it. Like, he, I love that last poem. That last poem got two. Because you said it was about your daughter. I got a 2-year-old.
So it's in me. Cooking her bottle. Winging it up, putting it in the bottle. I'm like, ah, get out of there. Get out. Hide yourself. It's just in me. It's in me. I just got out of work. I got moved, clocked out, came in. I did this whole set on my way here. Then I get here. First, I ain't gonna lie in this house. Not this house either. I might lie in my mama's house, but I ain't lying. I know I ain't gonna lie there. I'm gonna tell the truth. So I came up here just like I am. I ain't changed nothing. I put my door on. I don't care. Cause he know who I am.
That's right.
Both sides. Even when I have myself.
See, that right there
let you know that is embedded in our soul. Amen. Like you could be a one-year-old kid just born, and somebody in the house will say God is good at 1 year old. You probably be like, all the time. It's in our DNA, isn't it? That's one thing we do know. We might not know ABC. We know God is good. All the time. And all the time. My name is Rayahfoo. Thank y'all for having me.
Born by the river, and say, it's been a long time coming. Loneliness, I've had my share of loneliness. boy. Bruises, I'm taking my lumps and the bruises, but I'm healing. Yes, I am.
Says, there was also Benaniah, son of Jehoiada, a valiant warrior of Kazabil. He did many heroic deeds, which included killing two champions of Moab. Another time, on a snowy day, he chased a lion into a pit and killed it. Once armed only with a club, he killed an imposing Egyptian warrior who was armed with a spear. Benaniah wrenched the spear from the Egyptian's hand and killed him with it. Deeds like these made Benaniah famous as the three mightiest warriors. He was more honored than any of the other members of the 30, though he was not one of the three. And David made him captain of his bodyguard. Let us pray. God help me to preach. Amen. Amen. For the time that is ours to share with your prayers on God's power, Mr. Manning, I want to talk about mighty men in the camp. Mighty men in the camp. I believe I can say without fear of successful contradiction that one of the most beloved members, characters of the Bible is a brother by the name of David. You might know David. David was that shepherd boy that wasn't invited to the ordination service, only to find out that he was the only candidate for ordination. You might know David. David was that little lad that took a little lunch to a little location to find a big giant cussing out his loving Lord. He picks up five smooth stones, only needs one of them, hurls his face, and kills Goliath. David. David was the one that they sang sweet sonnets about in society when they said Saul has killed his thousands, but David has killed his 10,000s. You might know David. David was that lyrical prodigy that penned such songs in the Psalter, such as, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake." David was a man after God's own heart. He's had political triumphs, spiritual triumphs, and military triumphs. And 2 Samuel also deals with his transgressions. Because, see, David was minding his own business, so to speak, chilling out on the balcony of his palace until he looked beyond in the distance, saw something that he liked. He called that which he liked and initially engaged in a sinful act. Talks about his transgressions. But when we get to the end of 2 Samuel, we learn about his team. And friends, when we learn about David, how David came to rise, we learn that his success was not exempt the people that were around him. And friends, when we learn about David, I might suggest to us, family, the reason why he was able to have a high level of stability was because he had men in his camp. After the writer tells us all the intricacies of David's life, the writer does not allow us to leave his story without knowing the caliber of men that David had in his circle. All right. And I thought I might preach this today because it's important to God, and as he desires for us to live, grow, and worship in community. Did I say that too fast? I said God's desire for us is to live, grow, and worship in community. Some of us have a Biggie Winans theology. As long as I got King Jesus, I don't need nobody else. But that's a half truth. Jesus is indeed enough by himself for salvation, but he uses men and women to facilitate our faith fueling as we walk on this journey. And I don't know about you, but I need some mighty men in my camp. I need some men to help me fight against the Moabites and the Egyptians. I need some men in my camp to help me chase down lions on snowy days. I need some men in my camp to help me protect from armies of the enemy and redirect me from the army of the enemy. I need some men in my camp to pray for me when I don't feel like praying. I need some men in my camp to hold me accountable when I fall into seasons of spiritual slaughter. I need some mighty men in my camp. David had mighty men in his camp. 33 men. The writer could not close this contribution to the canon without mentioning these men. There's a big three of the highest order, and then there are 30 that follow. And if you'll allow me to zoom in on one of these 33 that David mentions in his camp, Benaiah gives us three factors that fuel our mentality as mighty men and women in the Lord's army. Are y'all interested this afternoon? First of all, mighty men and women of God heroically reframe hope into risk. I said we reframe hope into risk. Watch what happens. Bible says, verse 20, "Then also Benaiah, the son of Jehoiada, was a warrior. He did many heroic deeds, including killing two champions of Moab." Wow. Bible says he was a hero. And what made him a hero was the fact that he fought against two champions of Moab. The old King James calls them lion-like men. The implication here, Pastor, is Benaiah fought against two Moabites, which were the best that they had to offer, and they were as fierce as lions. I think, friends, the part of success of mighty men was not that he was intimidated by the illusion of the problem. I said he wasn't intimidated by the illusion of the problem. The problem wasn't a lion. It was men that looked like lions. And friends, sometimes we have to go through some things to reframe our faith in what appears to be risky and see hope in the situation. Come on, tell somebody that ain't a lion. That's just something that looks like a lion. If you just trust God long enough, you'll be able to see I used to watch country westerns with my daddy all the time. And this is what I discovered. When you watch country westerns, there's always a ballroom fight. Always a ballroom fight. But this is what blessed me. I wondered, why is it that when you see a ballroom fight, there's always one man fighting against at least five men? It's always one man fighting against five men. But what blessed me about every country western is that they never fight at the same time.
That's right.
It's one man against five, but they always fight one at a time. I said, now y'all don't judge me. I said, now I've been in a few fights in my life, and I never seen somebody jump somebody one at a time. Then it dawned on me. The reason why they fight one at a time is because the writer of the script would not allow the hero of the story to have an unfair advantage. And the reason why we can go through what we're going through in life is because the author of our story will never write a script to give us an unfair advantage. They reframe hope out of risk. But secondly, not only that, they don't haul off and run from harsh realities.
All right.
Bible says on another day, it was a snowy day. Wow. Where he chased a lion into a pit and killed it.
Uh-huh.
Now, some things are an illusion of the problem.
Uh-huh.
But some things are actually a problem. Look at your neighbor and say, yeah, that's a lion. But this is what blessed me. Mighty men and women don't run from their problems.
They chase after their problems.
This man had the most unfavorable circumstance in the most unfavorable conditions, and God brought him out victorious.
Right.
And I ought to have somebody here that can testify that I've been through some snowy days. I've had to fight through some lion's tigers and bears. Will God held my hand every step of the way? And here I can testify that he always gives me victory. They reframe hope in the risk. They don't haul off and run from harsh realities.
All right.
But thirdly and finally, mighty men in our camp, they embrace high responsibilities without needing high rankings.
All right.
Yeah, I say they embrace high responsibilities without needing high rankings.
All right.
I'm done, y'all. Watch what it says. Look what it says in verse 22. It says, these like these made Benaniah famous. He was honored more than the others of the 30, though he was not one of the three.
All right.
Writer lists the men in David's camp. There were three that had the highest rank and 30 that followed.
Uh-huh.
Bible says Benaniah was famous, but he wasn't one of the three.
All right.
He was famous. But he wasn't one of the three. See, here's where we get in trouble. We want high ranking with no responsibilities. But I need somebody in here with a Benaniah spirit that can testify, even if you don't pat me on the back, even if you don't mention my name, even if you don't write my name in lights, I'm still going to do it. Here's what blessed me. It says he was not one of the three, but David made him captain of his bodyguard. Ain't nobody happy but me. He was not one of the three, but David made him captain of the bodyguard. Which means, friends, he did not have the highest rank. But if anybody was going to get to David, they had to go through Benaniah. If they was going to get to David, they had to get through Benaniah. And Benaniah was the one that set out the cones in front of the church. Benaniah was the one that put all the lights off and made sure everything was good. Benaniah made sure that all the women made it to their cars safely. He did not have high ranking, but he was in charge of guarding the body of the king. And friends, what better responsibility do we have than protecting the body of the king? All of us in here are bodyguards, if you will. Because the enemy comes in and tries to attack the body of Christ. But I need a Benaniah in the house that can testify that if you ever come into the Lord's church, you will have to live through me. Now, if you're scared, say you're scared. But I need somebody that
were lost. If you would pray with me, let us bow our heads and go to God in prayer. Most holy and all-wise God.
UAP Radio.
Hold on, everybody. My name is Roger McLean of UAP Radio. Here where we offer photography, videography, DJing, podcasting, and develop social media / commercial content for business owners, entrepreneurs, educators, organizations, and creatives to help promote their events, products and services, special announcements, promotions, and more. So if you would like to book one of our services or see everything that we have to offer, go to uapradio.com and contact me today at 704-418-1876.
UAP Radio, I am for the voice of the Black community.